This lesson is meant for GSS 3 students. And the topic is export promotion in agriculture. Export promotion in agriculture. So when you look at this topic, it is similar to what you people have done in your previous classes. Like when you did cash crop and advertisement, the concept of cash crop and advertisement has something in common with this topic. So when you say cash crop are crops that are grown to meet international market, or crop grown for international market. While advertisement is the process of stimulating demand for a particular produce, or creating awareness about a particular produce. So you people have been taught like this in your previous class. So when we look at this export promotion in agriculture, if we want to relate cash crop and the concept of what advertisement, we can define export promotion as the encouragement of sales of agricultural produce in other countries. Encouragement of what? Sales of agricultural produce in other countries. So when you look at the definition, the keywords there are what? Encouragement of sales in other country. Encouragement of sales of agricultural produce in other country. But we cannot talk about sales without talking about encouragement of crop production in Nigeria. Though the main aspect of this topic is centered on encouragement of sales of agricultural produce in other countries. But we are going to talk briefly on the encouragement of crop production in Nigeria. So, for us to go into this one, we can view it from two perspectives. From the perspective of individual or farmer, and from perspective of what? Government or non-governmental organization. Then let's look at it from the perspective of individual or farmer. We have what we call value here. When you look at value is one of the factors that influences decision making. So for a farmer to go into large scale production, it is a thing of what? Interest. So you must attach importance to it, and that is the value we are talking about here. That is, you must have interest in going into large scale farming. So not only that, the interest we are talking about here still has to do with what? Zeal for going into what? Large-scale farming. So this is number one thing that a farmer has to have in his mind, which is value. You have to place value in whatever you are doing. You have to place value in order to what? In order to achieve your aim. Aim of what? Farming on a large scale. Then, having known this, we move to the second aspect of what a farmer has to do to be able to export his or her produce to other country. We have what we call cooperative farming. So this cooperative farming is the process of putting resources together. That is, two or more farmers can come together
and put their resources together, resources in terms of money, in terms of energy, in terms of skill, in terms of knowledge, they will put it together and give it to one person, one of their members in the group. Then that person will be able to what? Farm on a large scale that very year. Then the following year, they will do that to another person. Then they will do that until it will go round. This opportunity will what? Go round the members of the group. Then we have the last one here, ready to accept innovation. Ready to accept innovation. For somebody or a farmer to be able to farm on a large scale, you should be able to what? Accept new ideas, new ways of what? Farming. So these are the things that an individual or farmer can do in order to what? In order to produce on a large scale. So from the perspective of government, how can they encourage large scale production? One, they should try to encourage research institute. Encouraging research institute, agricultural research institute. So they should encourage them to go into research to come up with an improved seed that can produce high yield, that is good for what? Commercial agriculture. Then they should go into research to come up with discoveries, machineries that we can use on our soil here. So that is that, which is encouragement of what? Agricultural Research Institute in Nigeria. So government can encourage them, it can charge them for them to do more, to come up with research in order to boost agricultural production. So we have the next one here, which is still part of what? Government policy. Granting farmers loan request. Granting farmers loan request. Then government should also try to provide loan credit facilities to farmers to be able to what, farm on a large scale. Instead of asking for collateral, they should try and have a means of identifying genuine farmers, because not all farmers can present a collateral before they can get a loan. So we have solving problem of land tenure system. So we have problem of land ownership in Nigeria. So the problem of land ownership, whereby community will own land, family will have their land, clan will have their land, does not help export or farming on a large scale. So government has tried their best pertaining to this land tenure system in the past. So they still need to do more, because the problem still exists. This problem of land tenure system still exists in what, in Nigeria. So these are the ways we can what, encourage crop production in Nigeria. These are the ways we can encourage crop production in Nigeria. So let's quickly look at encouragement of sale in other countries. So how do we encourage sales of agricultural produce in other country from Nigeria? One, the first thing to do, if you want to export your agricultural produce to other country, you have to register your business with what? CAC, which is Corporate Affairs Commission. So the essence of registering with CAC is for you to have address in Nigeria, since you are dealing with prospective foreign customer. So they would like to have confidence in you. They would like to know where you live, your address. So you need to register so that whenever they want to search for your business, or they want to know where you are coming from, they can come to what? CAC and get your address. So the next one is to identify good market for your produce. Make sure you know which market in overseas have high demand for your produce. Is it Asia market? Is it American market? Is it European market? You try to know that. Then the next one, you search for customers. You have to search for what customer. Then how do you do that? You can advertise on website. You can design a website on web search engine like Google. So then you advertise your company, your agricultural company there. So this is the fastest way of what? Advertising your produce. Then the next one is to attend seminar to meet expert. To meet export business tycoon. To meet export business tycoon and stakeholders. And speak with friends and family members that live in overseas. They may be able to what? Give you the right connection you need in your business. Then the next one is to meet people that are already into the business. If you can meet people that are already into the business, they too can help you in giving you the right connection you need for your business, especially if they cannot meet the high demand of their customer. They can refer you to them. They can refer you to their customer. Then processing of document through authorized dealers. So having done this, when you talk about export business, it's all about documentation. It's all about what? Documentation. Then, because you that is exporting to other country, you need this document to be able to get your money, for you to be get paid, for you to be able as in for you to as in get your money. Then why the people or your customer abroad need the document so that he'll be able to what? Clear his goods in his own country. Then as for you to do this processing of document, you have to what? Register with what? Authorized dealer. Commercial bank, any commercial bank can do that for you. So when you register with commercial bank, they will be going to process a form known as NXP form or form NXP. So this form NXP contain your name. There's a place where you fill your name. It has Nigeria Export Promotion Council where you write their number. That shows that you have to register with Nigeria Export Promotion Council first before you even go for the processing of what of this document, this form NXP. Then the description of goods inside this form NXP. So you there's a place where you describe the goods. Then the performer invoice that you send to your customer abroad there. Then there's a space for your account so that when that customer in abroad is paying, you pay into your account. So these are the things that we need to know, and it can encourage us in our export business. So thank you for listening.